This is a facility for the elderly near Tokyo that is being run by a major insurance company group. They are testing a new method that could change how elder care is provided. The idea is to use the latest digital technology to visualize residents' lifestyle data and utilize it in their care. This is Tokuhisa Kyoko, who lives at this facility. She has been living with Parkinson's disease for over 10 years. Parkinson's is a neurological disorder that causes shaking or stiffness of the hands and feet. Several times a day, there are times when her symptoms worsen and she can't move at all. Thanks to the visualization of Tokuhisa's care data, one issue clearly stood out. This is her care data. It is divided into categories such as taking medication, getting dressed, and cleaning her living area. Above is her scheduled care, and below is the time her care was actually given. The dark blue shows that care was carried out, and the other colors indicate that care was not given for one reason or another. Tokuhisa's medication and getting dressed would proceed according to schedule. But it became clear that over half of her scheduled help using the restroom wasn't being carried out. This data visualization showed that Tokuhisa needed better help using the restroom. This is the specific data as to why she couldn't be helped using the restroom. The staff asked her over 10 times during the week if she needed help, but were turned down for a variety of reasons. When her symptoms are mild, she can use the restroom alone, but her condition's instability meant that it was difficult for staff to tell when she did and didn't need assistance. With help from her doctors, the staff adjusted the timing of her medication to times when her symptoms tended to be worse. As a result, she had less severe symptoms and didn't need the assistance to use the restroom. After integrating the data and adjusting her care to better her daily health and lifestyle rhythm, Tokuhisa's condition and mobility were markedly improved from when she first moved in. This shows Tokuhisa's transition. She began needing less time for her care since 2021. This is thanks to any member of the staff being able to give her the optimal care she needs at the time she needs it.
新人の職員さんであっても先輩と同じように見える化された水準で、同じような水準でお仕事ができるようになったのかなと思っています。
Digitalization is being implemented in many facilities, but this particular one is establishing a structure to optimize the usage of accumulated data. It's being used to optimize the planning of care for each of its residents. Planning requires a large amount of data, including everything from changes in weight and temperature day to day, to how much someone eats and their responses to staff. Entering a day's meals by carbohydrates and other dishes creates this graph of daily changes. Scrolling to the bottom of the screen gives an overview of temperature and weight changes as well, all on the same page. A sensor records movement, heart rate, and breathing during sleep. This data gives a better understanding of a resident's overall health.
データを 活用することによって ピンポイントでこの人が必要としているところが分かって そこに援助を加えることができるようになったっていうのは感じてますね 社長としては経験してますね
This is the resident data before the new system was incorporated. Finding information within these mountains of physical records was challenging, to say the least.
冊数とすれば1人10冊以上はあったので、はい。まず情報を取ってくるというのがとても手間でした。
By not only accumulating data, but creating a structure to use it effectively, they have improved the lives of residents and reduced the staff's workload. This facility's parent company, Sompo Holdings, has used the risk analysis and accident response expertise it has accumulated as a major insurance provider in the hopes of improving the quality of the elder care industry as a whole. How else can data visualization help to improve elder care?
やっぱりそこの働く人が働きがいを持って、まあ、もっと言うと分かりやすく楽しくですね、仕事をできる延長線上に質の高い介護ができるっていう、これ間違いないですから、だからそこを両方で、結果として介護事業者のその生産性が上がって、そして出た収益、上がった収益は処遇改善に回すと、職員の、そうすると三方よしになるわけです。これが僕は重要なキーファクターだなと思ってるんですね。はい。